I've been here for 5 years, and the things I'm most proud of is the culture of really high ambition that we have created here in the science department. And genuinely, the girls and the staff believe that anything is possible. We've totally changed our curriculum, so it's not specification focused, but more focused on the big ideas in science. And really, for us, it's big ideas without big budgets. We look at our local environment and we think, how could we use that more productively? Last year we really did go high and we put a teddy bear into space. We attached a teddy bear to an enormous helium balloon the size of a mini, and by the time it got up to 32,500 metres, it was the size of a double-decker bus before it burst and landed back in a muddy puddle in Bicester. But collecting the data from that has allowed us to do some really exciting stuff in class.
One of the great things about working with her is you can go into her and say, I've got a great idea, and she'll say, try it, see what happens. We're allowed to fail. We're allowed to fail big and do new and exciting things every single day.
Another example of something that people said we couldn't do was build a car. Now, we're a girls' school, we don't have wonderful mechanics suites, but I really did want to build a car. And next door, we're very lucky to have Springfields, which is a special school which has got the most amazing mechanics suite. So what we're doing now is working in a really fantastic partnership, a collaboration with some of our Year 12 physicists and some of their Year 10 students, and we're building a Westfield car. This is going to be an amazing event when we try it on the racetrack.
I've known Alex since she started, and she is a powerhouse. She's a friend, she's a scientist, she's an innovator, she's creative, but most of all, she's a great teacher and a great learner as well.
I really truly believe we're generating really good scientists for the future who are thinking and reading and becoming much more intellectually engaged in the world around them.
She publishes something called The Forum. Now, The Forum is a teaching and learning magazine where we get to share ideas about teaching and learning. And so people come to science and they say, that sounds like a great idea. How could I do X, Y, Z based on the thing I've talked about? She encourages people to talk. She encourages people to be part of a community, and she encourages us to see ourselves as reflective learners. I think that's a very difficult thing to do.
We look at our local environment and we think, how could we use that more productively? So we are really lucky to have a fantastic orchard here at St Mary's. We've turned that into an ongoing biodiversity project where we're monitoring the moths and feeding into the Wiltshire moth database. We're looking at lichens and monitoring air pollution. And we also have an apple day where we pick all the apples, press all the apples, get people in from the local community, and then I run an apple enterprise business, which means that the year 10s are generating their own little business and some profit for them to spend in school.
I think one of the things that's most interesting is that she's keen to prepare people for the world that they're going to go into, not the world that we grew up in. Because she recognises that learners and creative people will develop a fantastic new world that will be very different from the world that we grew up in.
So my advice to future leaders in science education is to read, 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 to be interested in absolutely everybody that you meet, to aim really high, because even if you only make it halfway, the journey is going to be really exciting.